Hantavirus is a life-threatening disease that is spread to humans by rodents and has symptoms similar to influenza. Hantavirus is carried by rodents, especially deer mice. The virus is found in the urine and feces, but it doesn't make the animals sick. It is believed that humans get sick with this virus if they come in contact with the contaminated dust from mice nests or droppings. You may come in contact with such dust when cleaning homes, sheds, or other enclosed areas that have been emptied for a long time. Hantavirus does not spread between humans. Rodents carrying the hantavirus have been found in many United States national parks. Campers and hikers may be more likely to catch the disease than most people. This is because they pitch tents in forest floors and lay their sleeping bags down in musty cabins. On September 13, 2012, the National Park Service announced a total of 9 confirmed cases of hantavirus infection in people who recently visited Yosemite National Park. However, only a couple of cases have been directly linked to camping or hiking. Most people who are exposed to the virus have come in contact with rodent droppings in their own homes. The early symptoms of hantavirus disease are similar to the flu and include chills, fever, and muscle aches. People with hantavirus may begin to feel better for a very short amount of time, but within 1-2 days, it becomes hard to breathe. The disease gets worse quickly, and the symptoms include dry cough, general ill feeling like malaise, headache, nausea and vomiting, and shortness of breath. So you can see why it's so hard to make that diagnosis, and history is very important. Physical exam may reveal acute respiratory distress syndrome, or ARDS. Kidney failure, low blood pressure or hypertension, and low oxygen levels, or cyanosis, when the skin starts turning blue, discolored because of the low oxygen. The following tests may be done. Blood tests. To check for signs of hantavirus infection, like a complete blood cell count, or CBC, a kidney and liver function tests, an x-ray of the chest to rule out pulmonary involvement. People with hantavirus are often admitted to the hospital, and many of the times to the intensive care unit. The treatment will include oxygen, a breathing tube or breathing machine, especially in severe cases, a medication called ribavirin to treat kidney-related problems and reduce the overall risk of death. There is no effective treatment against hantavirus infection that involves the lungs. So what is the prognosis or expectations of hantavirus infection? Hantavirus is a serious infection that gets worse quickly. Lung failure can occur and may lead to death. Even with aggressive treatment and management, more than half of the people who have this disease in their lungs die. So if you have flu-like symptoms after coming in contact with rodent droppings or rodent urine or dust that might be contaminated with the substance, call your doctor or go to the emergency department right away. The best way is to prevent the disease. Avoid exposure to rodent urine and droppings. When hiking and camping, pitch tents in areas where there are no rodent droppings. Drink disinfected water and avoid rodent dens. Sleep on a ground cover and pad. And keep your home clean. Clear out potential nesting sites and clean your kitchen. If you must work in an area where contact with rodent urine or feces is possible, you must follow the recommendations from the Center of Disease Control and Prevention, which are the following. When you open an unused cabin, shed, or building, open all the doors and windows, leave the building, and allow the space to dry out for 30 minutes. Return to the building and spray the surface, carpet, and other areas with disinfectant. Leave the building again for another 30 minutes. Spray mouse nests and dropping with 10% solution of chlorine bleach or similar disinfectant. Allow it to sit for about 30 minutes using rubber gloves. Place the materials in plastic bags. Seal the bags and throw them in the trash or an incinerator. And dispose the gloves and cleaning materials in the same manner. Wash all potential contaminated hard surface with bleach or disinfectant solution, and avoid vacuuming until the areas have been thoroughly decontaminated. Then vacuum the first few times with enough ventilation, and wear a surgical mask that will help protect you from inhaling these particles.